brothers and sisters to increase your iman. Read the miracle, recite the Quran. Recite it every day and do read it loud. The verses of Quran are all Muslim's pride. This miracle was revealed over a long time span, sent from Allah to an angel, then to a man. That man was Muhammad, the best of creation.
Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Brothers and sisters, welcome to another live edition of your program, Correct Your Citation. In the beginning, I praise Allah, the Almighty alone, and send peace and blessings upon His most beloved Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Then I would like also to welcome our studio guest. Assalamu alaikum, Ahmed Ibrahim. Remind me with your name.
Fahim.
Fahim and Ismail. Am I right?
Naam.
Barakallah feekum. Thank you so much for joining us. Barakallah feekum. Inshallah, today, as usual, in our program, Correct Your Recitation, we'll begin by reciting the verses that we're planning to explain their meaning. Then we'll follow that by the tafsir, and in the next segment, inshallah, I'll be more than happy to take your calls for those who would like to recite with us in order to experiment the recitation or even correct the recitation. So without any further ado, I will begin with reciting from ayah number 21 through ayah number 25, inshallah, and I hope Allah will make it easy for us to cover these ayat with the tafsir, inshallah, over the next few minutes. أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم سابقوا إلى مغفرة من ربكم وجنة عرضها كعرض السماء والأرض وجنة عرضها كعرض السماء والأرض أعدت للذين آمنوا بالله ورسله ذلك فضل الله يؤتيه من يشاء والله ذو الفضل العظيم ما أصاب من مصيبة في الأرض ولا في أنفسكم إلا في كتاب من قبل أن نبرأها إن ذلك على الله يسير لكي لا تأسوا على ما فاتكم ولا تفرحوا بما آتاكم والله لا يحب كل مختال فخور الذين يبخلون ويأمرون الناس بالبخل ومن يتول فإن الله هو الغني الحميد لقد أرسلنا رسلنا بالبينات وأنزلنا معهم الكتاب والميزان ليقوم الناس بالقسط وأنزلنا الحديد فيه بأس شديد ومنافع للناس وليعلم الله من ينصره ورسله بالغيب إن الله قوي عزيز سابقوا إلى مغفرة من ربكم وجنة عرضها كعرض السماء والأرض. Which means, rather than competing with one another over the dunya, which the previous ayah explained clearly that it is transient, it is insignificant, it is just a bridge, and no one is gonna live there forever. No one is immortal. So it's a matter of test and trial. لِيَبْلُوَكُمْ أَيُّكُمْ أَحْسَنُ عَمَلًا. He only created us in order to test us over a short period of time, 60, 70, 80, more or less, which one of us is best indeed. Then afterward, there will be reckoning. So this home is a home of work, and the other home is the eternal life, which is a home of reckoning and hisab. Then reward or punishment. So why would you then compete over a transient thing? Something that which you cannot control and own forever. It is basically temporary. Rather than competing over the dunya, compete with regards to the everlasting gain, the everlasting life. سابقوا, that is the meaning of the word سابقوا, from السباق, which is the race, towards. Normally when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala orders us to race towards heaven, He introduces to that, but what normally leads to heaven, which is forgiveness. In ayah number 133 of Surah Al-Imran, the third chapter of the Quran, similarly, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, وَسَارِعُوا إِلَى مَغْفِرَةٍ مِّن رَبِّكُمْ وَجَنَّةٍ عَرْضُهَا. The same thing, race, be quick, compete with one another towards what? مغفرة من ربكم وجنة عرضها السماء والأرض أعدت للمتقين. Here in this ayah, عرضها كعرض السماء والأرض. So السباق, المسابقة, المسارعة, and التنافس. In ayah number 26 of Surah المطففين, when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala before that mentioned, إن الأبرار لفي نعيم. The fate of the righteous ones, he said, وفي ذلك فَلْيَتَنَافَسِ الْمُتَنَافِسُونَ. Let the competitors compete over what? Over paradise, over heaven, and what Allah has prepared for the believers in heaven. يُسْقَوْنَ مِنْ رَحِيقٍ مَخْتُومٍ خِتَامُهُ مِسْكٍ وَفِي ذَلِكَ فَلْيَتَنَافَسِ الْمُتَنَافِسُونَ. That is ayah number 26 of Surah Al-Mutaffifin. So repeatedly in the Quran, Allah urged the believers to compete with one another, to race, to rush and to haste towards what? Number one, forgiveness. In order to make it to heaven, you gotta be forgiven. And the Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, truly, none of you shall enter paradise simply because of your good or righteous deeds. Because no matter how many good deeds one has, it isn't enough to give thanks or to compensate for a single blessing of the countless blessings that Allah bestowed upon us. وَإِن تَعُدُّوا نِعْمَةَ اللَّهِ لا تحصوها. If you try to count Allah's blessings upon you, never will you be able to keep record. So no matter how much you worship Allah, how many good deeds you do, that is not enough to match the blessings of a single ni'mah that Allah bestowed upon you. So number one, you need this forgiveness for our shortcomings, for not fulfilling exactly what we were ordered to do in order to be eligible to enter al-Jannah. إذن سابقوا إلى مغفرة ذن جنة. Forgiveness ذن جنة. وسارعوا إلى مغفرة من ربكم ذن وجنة عرضها السماوات والأرض وعدت للمتقين. As far as the width of the heavens, الجنة. Because when the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم said that the share of the least person in paradise would be 10 times the size of this dunya and what it contains, then what will be the share of the highest person? And how many people will enter Al-Jannah? Al-Jannah is very vast. Its vastness is as vast as the solar system entirely and the entire universe. Not our only Earth planet. Our Earth planet is like a drop in an ocean compared to other planets. This entire universe, Al-Jannah, will be as wide as the entire universe and all the different galaxies. So it will encompass all the believers, and there is plenty of room for all the believers from Adam alayhi salam till the end of time. Rejoice and do not be worried. Rather, you just need to compete over what? Not over the dunya. Allah mentioned competition in the Quran in two different forms. One which is praiseworthy, and He urged us to compete in this field towards forgiveness and Jannah, towards doing good deeds. And he mentioned their competition in an unpraiseworthy form when he said, أَلْهَاكُمُ التَّكَاثُرُ. He dispraised that. Competition over the dunya kept you busy, diverted you from the main purpose of life. And the Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, upon reading this ayah, he said, أَلْهَاكُمُ التَّكَاثُرُ. He said, the son of Adam keeps saying, Mali, Mali, my worth, my property, my car, my business, my villa, my house. And the Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam has invited us to focus on the reality of your wealth. What do you actually possess of your wealth? He said, is there anything that you actually possess of your wealth other than what you eat and excrete, what you wear until you tear, or what you give in a charity, and that is your actual saving with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Other than that, you know, the richest person in the world now possesses like $80 billion. Okay, how much does he actually possess of that? Only what he enjoys in this life. But if he drops dead right now, everything will go to somebody else. So it's not actually your wealth. So the competition is dispraised in this field. In a sense that when a person spends their entire lifetime competing over the dunya, and they have no share, we just finished Hajj, right? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala dispraised and condemned those who focus in their dua on the dunya. In the ayah, which is the conclusion of Hajj, فَإِذَا قَضَيْتُم مَنَاسِكَكُمْ, when you finish the manasik, فَاذْكُرُوا اللَّهَ كَذِكْرِكُمْ آبَاءَكُمْ أَوْ أَشَدِّ ذِكْرًا, then he condemned those who focus in their dua on the dunya. فَمِنَ النَّاسِ مَنْ يَقُولُ رَبَّنَا أَتِنَا فِي الدُّنْيَا, give me good wife, a job, a house, prosperity, health, blah, 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 only dunya. وَمَّا لَهُ فِي الْآخِرَةِ مِنْ خَلَاقٍ. Well, you may assume that Allah afterward will propose, will recommend, and will urge us to ask only for al-akhirah. No, not that even. Rather, keep in balance is what Allah wants us to do. He said, وَمِنْهُمْ وَمِنْهُمْ مَنْ يَقُولُ رَبَّنَا آتِنَا فِي الدُّنْيَا حَسَنَةً وَفِي الْآخِرَةِ حَسَنَةً وَقِنَا عَذَابَ النَّارِ. أُولَٰئِكَ لَهُمْ نَصِيبٌ مِمَّا كَسَبُوا وَاللَّهُ سَرِيعُ الْحِسَابِ. Well, Allah recommended and approved the smart people, the true believers who say, oh Allah, give us a goodly hasana, goodly reward in this life. What you name it? The wife, the business, the prosperity, the health, the children. وَفِي الْآخِرَةِ حَسَنَةً, and also give us a goodly reward in the hereafter. حَسَنَةُ الْآخِرَةِ is what? الْجَنَّةِ. That is the greatest hasana, the goodly reward of the hereafter. Okay, you will get a share of what you ask for. You'll get from the dunya and you'll get from al-akhirah. And Allah is quick in reckoning. So basically, ask from Allah both and work for both and keep balance, but do not let the dunya transgress over al-akhirah. That what matters most. أُعِدَّتْ لِلَّذِينَ آمَنُوا بِاللَّهِ وَرُسُلِهِ. This paradise is not for everyone. It's only for those who worked hard for it. They believed in Allah وَرَسُولِهِ وَرُسُلِهِ. Al-Rusul is plural. And it means and his messengers. And the fourth article of Iman in Islam is Al-Iman of Rusul, to believe in Allah, His angels, His, and تؤمن بالله ملائكته وكتبه, His books, and His messengers. That is the fourth article. Did he ever hear of any Muslim who said, I don't believe in Jesus? Could he imagine a Muslim who said, I don't believe in Moses, he's the prophet of the Jews? لا. He is the prophet of Islam, Musa is the prophet of Islam, Zakari is the prophet of Islam. إِنَّ الدِّينَ عِنْدَ اللَّهِ الْإِسْلَامِ. أَمْ كُنْتُمْ شُهَدَاءَ إِذْ حَضَرَ يَعْقُوبَ الْمَوْتُ إِذْ قَالَ لِبَنِيهِ مَا تَعْبُدُونَ مِنْ بَعْدِهِ. Remember? When Jacob, who's Jacob? Yaqub alayhi salam, Israel. At the time of death, he gathered his son, Yusuf, Benjamin, and the other guys. He said, what are you going to worship after me? قَالُوا نَعْبُدُ إِلَهَكَ وَإِلَهَ آبَكَ إِبْرَاهِيمَ, huh? وَإِسْمَعِيلَ وَإِسْحَاقَ. Right? We're going to worship whom? We're going to worship the Lord of you and your forefathers, your fathers, Prophet Ibrahim, Prophet Ishaq, and Ismail. إِلَهًا وَاحِدًا. He is one single إله, one single God. وَنَحْنُ لَهُ Muslimun. And we all submit ourselves unto him in worship. So all the prophets believed in the oneness of Allah, preached the same. تقوا الله وأطيعون عبدوا الله وأطيعون worship Allah alone and obey me. I'm conveying the message of Allah unto you. Okay. ذلك فضل الله يؤتيه من يشاء. You're not going to enter al-Jannah against Allah's will. This is a bounty, a gift from Allah, whom He grants to whomever He wills. This is a blessing of Allah. He grants to whomever He wills. والله ذو الفضل العظيم. And Allah has the greatest bounty. Ya Allah, we seize this opportunity to ask Allah out of His bounty to gather us by His mercy in His heaven. اللهم اجمعنا في جنتك برحمتك. آمين. ما أصاب من مصيبة في الأرض ولا في أنفسكم إلا في كتاب من قبل أن نبرأها. Which means no calamity, no tests and trials that befalls on the earth, في الأرض ولا في أنفسكم. في الأرض such as what? Famines, droughts, earthquakes, volcanoes, tornadoes, hurricanes, mass destructions. Okay. ولا في أنفسكم, no in within yourselves, your person, such as disease, sickness, loss of properties, loss of wealth, loss of loved ones, loss of lives. In Surah Al-Baqarah, in ayah number 155, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala announced that no one can escape trials. No one would live in this life without being tested and tried. Believers and non-believers. When He said, subhanahu wa ta'ala, ولنبلونكم بشيء من الخوف والجوع ونقص من الأموال والأنفس والثمرات وبشر الصابرين. So your only choice as a believer is to be patient. Is to be patient. You will be tried by fear, something of fear, of hunger, of loss of properties, of loss of loved ones, of loss of lives, of sickness. And give glad tidings to الصابرين. الاختبار or al-bala, tests and trials, do not only refer to calamities which we perceive as bad things or evil or devastations, but also it refers to good things. They are also means of trials. Remember when we studied before, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, وَعَلَمُوا أَنَّمَا أَمْوَالُكُمْ وَأَوْلَادُكُمْ فِتْنَة. Know that your wealth and your sons are but a trial, a test and trials, and Allah has a great reward. Okay. In Surah Al-Anbiya, ayah number 35, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, كُلُّ نَفْسٍ ذَائِقَةُ الْمَوْتِ. Most certainly, assuredly, every soul shall taste death. Agreed upon that. Believers and non-believers. وَنَبْلُوكُمْ بِالشَّرِّ وَالْخَيْرِ فِتْنَةً وَإِلَيْنَا تُرْجَعُونَ. Between life and death, nothing but trials. Trials of what? Of what is bad and of what is good. Imagine when your wife, your children, your wealth, your health are nothing but means of tests and trials. أموالكم وأولادكم اعلموا أنما أدات حصر وقصر. For sure, your wealth, your children, your possessions are nothing but means of tests and trials. يرحمكم الله. Ibrahim alayhi salam was tested, number one, by not having a child until he was 86 years old. Then Allah tested him by granting him the child. Look how this test took place. After having the child, Ibrahim was most pleased with having a child. Finally, he's got a son. Oh, he wasn't even able to spend a few months with him. He was older. I mean, he was tested to take him to the desert. ربنا إني أسكنت من ذريتي بواد غير ذي زرع عند بيتك. And he said it. He said, I took my family to a place, to a valley which have no life. No plants, nothing. That's a test. When did he get to see him again? Only when his son grew up and he was capable to work on his own and support. Okay. And when he came to visit him this time, it was not for family reunion. It was not to attend his wedding. فلما بلغ معه السعي سورة الصفات قال يا بني إني أرى في المنام أني أذبحك فانظر ماذا ترى. That's another test. You guys think that only Ibrahim عليه السلام was tested with his son or in his family. لا, each and every one of us. I say, may Allah protect us and all our children. Imagine when one's daughter is leaving home with those tight pair of jeans and look hot and blouses and all of that. That's a test. The father is being tested by the means of his own daughter, whom he loves so much. And the son, not only the daughter, I'm just giving an example. He loves her so much, he doesn't want to disappoint her. He doesn't want to upset her. He says, honey, this is not right. Dress up properly in here. Ah, daddy, please, and so on. Okay. And he just go. He failed the test. He loved his daughter more than Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He knows what is right and what is wrong, but he can't say no to his daughter. He can say no to his son. Did you pray today? Oh, I'm tired. I've been studying all day. Inshallah, I will do it in the summer vacation. In the summer, I was worn out. All day I was practicing basketball and so many things. Tests or not tests? Tests. أموالكم وأولادكم. You find a person who got barely 20 grands, finds it easy to pay the zakah because it's like what? 500 bucks, right? But a person who is a billionaire is required to pay what? Huh? Is required to pay a lot. We're talking about 250 million. He would be so much reluctant. He's tested with his wealth or not. He's tested. I'm just giving examples, but the tests and the trials are many. The poor have their own test, and the rich have their own test. But bottom line, you gotta keep in mind that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, مَا أَصَابَ مِن مُصِيبَةٍ فِي الْأَرْضِ وَلَا فِي أَنفُسِكُمْ. No test or trial that befell earth or within your persons. But it was all pre-recorded في كتاب. الكتاب refers to what? اللوح المحفوظ, the preserved tablet. Abdullah ibn Amr ibn al-As, may Allah be pleased with him, narrated a hadith which is collected by Imam Muslim. It's a sound hadith in which he says, I have heard Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam saying, قدر الله المقادير قبل أن يخلق السماوات والأرض بخمسين ألف سنة. And this hadith will explain the ayah right now. It says that he heard the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam saying that Allah has preordained all the maqadir, all the destiny, the preordainment, the destination of everything that exists. Not only us, 50,000 years before he created the heavens and the earth. Before he created the heavens and the earth. This is like a very essential hadith in understanding and comprehending the concept of al-qadr, destiny and preordainment. When Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, مِن قَبِلِ أَنَّ بْرَأَهَا, that was recorded in the book, in the preserved tablet, before it was created. نَبْرَأَهَا, we created, okay. Well, the pronoun it, which is ha, if we can zoom into the last two letters, the ha and alf in the word nabra'aha. You know the word nabra'aha contains what? The subject, which is na, we. Yabra, create, that is a verb. So we have a subject, we have a verb, and we have a direct object, who is ha. The ha refers to what? It may refer to the calamity itself, and it may refer to the earth and those who were created to live on earth. So the pronoun may refer to either one. In the Arabic grammar, you know, they say that الضمير يعود على أقرب مذكور. So what is the closest to the pronoun? الأرض وفي أنفسكم. In either case, it really means that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has recorded and preordained those calamities, whether good or bad. Ayah number 35 of Surah Al-Anbiya. وَنَبْلُوكُمْ بِالشَّرِّ وَالْخَيْرِ فِتْنَةً. It's a trial. وَإِلَيْنَا تُرْجَعُونَ. And by the end, unto us, you shall return. Okay. So that was all recorded before we were created, or before the heavens and the earth were created, or before the calamity itself was caused to exist. Either way,
What can you do about that? What can you do about that, Fahim? If Allah has preordained for you to be born, can you stop that? If Allah has preordained for you to die, to get sick, or to be rich, or to be the president of the United States of America, can anyone stop that? No, no one can stop that. Because of that, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, لِكَيْ لَا تَأْسَوْ عَلَى مَا فَاتَكُمْ وَلَا تَفْرَحُوا بِمَا آتَاكُمْ. Very important. So that you may not grieve over or for what has escaped you, nor rejoice or over-rejoice because of what Allah has bestowed upon you or granted you. Wait a minute. This is a little confusing. You know, I may, once I read the literal meaning, I get confused. So Allah doesn't want us to be sad nor happy? No, it doesn't mean that. It means, as Ikrimah, one of the great interpreters of the Quran, the student of Ibn Abbas, Tarjuman al-Quran, said, لَيْسَ مِنْ أَحَدٍ إِلَّا يَفْرَحُ وَيَحْزَنُ. Is there anyone who does not grieve and does not celebrate, exalt, and show happiness? Everyone, including the Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. When the Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam knows his son Ibrahim, was he like numb? Not reacting whatsoever? Did he show happiness? Was he grieved? Yes, of course he was sad. He grieved. And he expressed that verbally. He said, إِنَّ الْعَيْنَ لَتَدْمَعَ. And he was crying, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. وَإِنَّ الْقَلْبَ لَيَحْزَنَ. And my heart is grieved. Why? For the death of his son. Yet, وَلَا نَقُولُ إِلَّا مَا يُرْضِ الرَّبِّ. But I do not let my grief overcome my emotion, so I would make a statement that displeases Allah or object to his decree. That is the meaning of لِكَيْ لَا تَأْسَوْ عَلَى مَا فَاتَكُمْ وَلَا تَفْرَحُوا بِمَا آتَاكُمْ. So he said, there is none, but he grieves and he rejoices. وَلَكِنْ يَتْ اِجْعَلُوا الْفَرَحَ شُكْرًا وَالْحُزْنَ صَبْرًا. The best way to express your joy and delight, rejoicing, by being grateful, showing gratitude to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And there is a dua upon receiving every good thing that you say. You know, if you're for wearing something new, for receiving a new baby, you turn to Allah with gratitude for getting married and so on. Alhamdulillah, Rabbil Alameen, for eating and drinking. Walhuzna sabra. And make your grief, your sorrow, and your sadness, instead of showing an objection to Allah's decree, convert into patience. وبشر الصابرين الذين إذا أصابتهم مصيبة قالوا إنا لله وإنا إليه راجعون أولئك عليهم صلوات من ربهم ورحمة وأولئك هم المهتدون. You endure these calamities patiently. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will bestow His mercy upon you and you will be rightly guided. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make us among them. Unfortunately, we won't be able to take the remaining verses. The remaining two verses, because we ran out of time. We're going to take a short break. We'll be back, inshallah, in a couple of minutes. Please stay tuned.
And do read it loud. Recite it every day and do read it loud.
Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh, and welcome back. In this segment, as we said, we're going to focus on reciting, explaining, and commenting on some of the ahkam of the tajweed in this ayat from ayah number 21 through 25, inshallah. Let's stick to 24, okay? So next time, inshallah, we'll begin from ayah number 25. Barakallahu feekum. We'll begin with our studio guest. The numbers should appear on the screen. It's been a while, so I don't have them in my memory. And they keep changing the numbers. It's hard to remember them. So you can copy the numbers from the screen, inshallah. We'll begin with Brother Ahmed from ayah number 21. Sabiqu.
A'udhu billahi minash shaytanir rajim. Sabiqu ila maghfiratin min rabbikum wa jannah. وَجَنَّةٍ عَرْضُهَا كَعَرْضِ السَّمَاءِ وَالْأَرْضِ أُعِدَّتْ لِلَّذِينَ آمَنُوا بِاللَّهِ وَرُسُلِهِ ذَلِكَ فَضْلُ اللَّهِ يُؤْتِيهِ مَنْ يَشَاءُ وَاللَّهُ ذُو الْفَضْلِ الْعَظِيمِ ما أصاب من مصيبة في الأرض ولا في أنفسكم إلا في كتاب من قبل أن نبرأها إن ذلك على الله يسير لكي لا تأسوا على ما فاتكم ولا تفرحوا بما آتاكم والله لا يحب كل مختال فخور الذين يبخلون ويأمرون الناس بالبخل وَمَنْ يَتَوَلَّ فَإِنَّ اللَّهَ هُوَ الْغَنِيُّ الْحَمِيدُ
حسبك ما شاء الله very correct بارك الله فيك إبراهيم begin with سابقوا
أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم سابقوا إلى مغفرة من ربكم وجنة عرضها كعرض السماء والأرض أعدت للذين آمنوا بالله ورسله ذلك فضل الله يؤتيه من يشاء والله ذو الفضل العظيم
حسبك wait a minute إن شاء الله we'll come back to this ayah but after we take sister Tawbah from the KSA السلام عليكم sister Tawbah
وعليكم السلام
how are you
I'm fine alhamdulillah
okay today we're reading from ayah 21 through ayah 24 That is page number 540 of the Quran, Surah Al-Hadid, chapter number 57. Go ahead and begin with سابقوا.
أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. سابقوا إلى مغفرة من ربكم وجنة عرضها كعرض السماء والأرض. عرضها كعرض السماء والأرض أعدت للذين آمنوا بالله ورسله ذلك فضل الله يؤتيه من يشاء والله ذو الفضل العظيم ما أصاب من مصيبة في الأرض ولا في أنفسكم إلا في كتاب من قبل إلا في كتاب من قبل أن نبرأها إن ذلك على الله يسير لكي لا تأسوا على ما فاتكم ولا تفرحوا بما آتاكم والله لا يحب كل مختال فخور للذين يبخلون ويأمرون
توبة الذين يبخلون not للذين okay
الذين يبخلون ويأمرون الناس بالبخل ومن يتولى فإن الله هو الغني الحميد
حسبك حسبك thank you توبة جزاك الله خيرا okay now you made a mistake you made her follow you in that mistake which is الضاد Is the Dhad one of the letters of the Qalqala? What are the letters of Qalqala? Five. Qutub, Jad. Qutub, not Qubub. So there is no Dhad. So Al-Qalqala, whenever any of these five letters, Al-Qaf, Al-Ta, Al-Ba, Al-Jim, and Al-Dal, these five letters happen to be
with sukun, or the Indo-Pak, they call it jazm. Then you apply the qalqala, you shake the letter. But ad-dad must be whenever it is second, and you pronounce it clearly with sukun, and you don't move it, you don't shake it, because once you shake it, it's like you give it a fatha. ذَلِكَ فَضْلُ اللَّهِ. You don't apply qalqala to the dad whatsoever. Okay? ذَلِكَ فَضْلُ اللَّهِ يُؤْتِيهِ مَنْ يَشَاءُ. Did you hear the hamza? Yes, because it's a letter. Not because you apply the mad, you fade the mad, and you do not pronounce the hamza. Look, what some people would say, ذَلِكَ فَضْلُ اللَّهِ يُؤْتِيهِ مَنْ يَشَاءُ. That's wrong. You're missing a letter, which is Al-Hamza. Al-Tahqiq is to pronounce each letter and to give it its proper characteristics, whether it's Tafkhim, Tahqiq, Al-Hams, فَحَثَّهُ شَخْصٌ سَكَتْ, right? Yeah. So you have to apply these rules. وَاللَّهُ ذُو الْفَضْلِ الْعَظِيمِ. Say, وَاللَّهُ ذُو الْفَضْلِ الْعَظِيمِ. Just read this. We have another phone. We'll get back to you. But just say, وَاللَّهُ.
والله ذو الفضل العظيم.
فضل العظيم. You stop. I mean, you do not stop, but rather you do not give any vowel. والله ذو الفضل العظيم. Okay. Once you know how to do this with the dad, then throughout the Quran, it's easy and affordable. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullah. Sister Zahra from Nigeria. Assalamu alaikum. Go ahead.
أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. سابقوا إلى مغفرة من ربكم وجنة عرضها كعرض السماء والأرض. أعدت للذين آمنوا بالله ورسله. ذلك فضل الله يؤتيه من يشاء والله ذو فضل عظيم. ما أصاب من مصيبة في الأرض ولا في أنفسكم إلا في كتاب من قبل أن نبرأ. ذلك على الله يسير لكي لا تأسوا على ما فاتكم ولا تفرحوا بما آتاكم والله لا يحب كل مختال فخور. الذين يبخلون ويأمرون الناس بالبخل ومن يتول فإن الله هو الغني الحميد.
ما شاء الله. It's very obvious that our young viewer from Nigeria, Sister Zahra, have been influenced by the recitation of Sheikh Abu Bakr al-Shatri big time. Ma sha Allah. It's beautiful to be listening to a particular qari and reciter as long as his recitation is proper and you try to imitate him. Barakallahu fiki. Thank you, Zahra. And since you're calling from Nigeria, I would like to extend my gratitude to all Nigerian viewers. They stop me everywhere in the haram, whether in Mecca or Medina. These brothers and sisters are very sincere, mashallah. They love Huda TV so much. And may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bless you all. Barakallah fiqh. Tayyib, ya Ibrahim, ma asaba.
Ma asaba min musibatin fil ardi wala fi anfusikum illa fi kitab min qabli an nabra'aha inna dhalika 'ala Allahi yaseer likay la ta'asaw 'ala ma fatakum wala tafrahu
افرحوا بما آتاكم والله لا يحب كل مختال فخور الذين يبخلون ويأمرون الناس بالبخل ومن يتول فإن الله هو الغني الحميد.
ما شاء الله يا إبراهيم جزاك الله خيرا. Very proud of you. Ibrahim is from Bosnia. ما شاء الله he is studying Sharia. This is your last year, right? So inshallah in a few months he will be going back home to teach his fellow Bosnian citizens the proper Sharia and Islam. So he has a lot of things to do, and on his shoulders is a great heavy duty. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala assist you guys in fulfilling this duty. I remember Dino, Khalid, and Ismir, all of you. MashaAllah. May Allah bless you all. Fahim, go ahead.
أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم سابقوا إلى مغفرة من ربكم وجنة أرضها كأرض السماء والأرض
سيعين
وجنة أرضها كأرض
سيعين سيعين عين
عين
أع عرضها
عرضها
excellent this is how I want to hear it from you Okay. وجنة عرضها كعرضي
وجنة عرضها كعرض السماء والأرض أعدت للذين آمنوا بالله ورسله ذلك فضل الله يؤتيه من يشاء والله ذو الفضل العظيم
great ما شاء الله
ما أصاب من مصيبة في الأرض ولا في أنفسكم إلا في كتاب من قبل أن نبرأها إن ذلك على الله يسير لكي لا تأسوا على ما فاتكم ولا تفرحوا بما آتاكم والله لا يحب كل مختال فخور الذين يبخلون ويأمرون الناس بالبخل ومن يتول فإن الله هو الغني الحميد
حسبك ما شاء الله very good بارك الله فيك we have إسماعيل from Senegal you're from Senegal right
I'm Sierra Leone
Sierra Leone yeah. how far is Senegal from Sierra Leone
it's far maybe far. Yes maybe two hours flight
you know sometimes to go to some countries in Africa itself Yes. It takes me a longer time than flying to Washington, D.C.
yes.
Because like going to Burundi, to Rwanda, it takes like 16 hours or so because there is no direct flight. So I have to fly from one country to another.
Yeah.
Inshallah, one day we have the United countries of Africa.
Inshallah.
All the Muslim countries, inshallah.
Inshallah.
Assalamu alaikum, Sister Aisha from the KSA.
Wa alaikum salam wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.
We're reciting today from ayah number 21 through ayah 24 of Surah Al-Hadid.
Okay. أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. سابقوا إلى مغفرة من ربكم وجنة عرضها كعرض السماء والأرض أعدت للذين آمنوا بالله ورسله ذلك فضل الله يؤتي من يشاء والله ذو الفضل العظيم ما أصاب من مصيبة في الأرض ولا في أنفسكم إلا في كتاب من قبل أن نبرأها إن ذلك على الله يسير لكي لا تعثوا على ما فاتكم ولا تفرحوا بما آتاكم والله لا يحب كل محسن فخور
مختال فخور والله لا يحب كل مختال فخور
والله لا يحب كل مختال فخور
مختال فخور
مختال فخور الذين يبخلون ويعمرون الناس بالبخل ومن يتولى فإن الله هو الغني الحميد
حسبك بارك الله فيك And just a reminder that in the first ayah There is tanween beneath the ta al-marbuta of وَجَنَّةٍ عَرْضُهَا So you must pronounce a tanween because it's followed by عَيْن So that's called what? إظهار إظهار حقيقي or إظهار حلقي Because of the letter عَيْن It comes from the throat So you must pronounce the عَيْن clearly And you must pronounce al-ghunnah which sounds like نون يسي وجنة عرضها بارك الله فيك سيستر عائشة جزاك الله خيرا كثيرا finally اسماعيل from Sierra Leone
بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم سابقوا إلى مغفرة من ربكم وجنة عرضها كعرض السماء والأرض أعدت للذين آمنوا بالله ورسوله ذلك فضل الله يؤتيه من يشاء والله ذو الفضل العظيم
إن شاء الله overall you're doing great we'll recite this ayah again then we'll focus on you know some letters maybe have been mispronounced try to correct them go ahead again
سابقوا إلى المغفرة من ربكم
there is no alif and lam before المغفرة so it is سابقوا إلى مغفرة
سابقوا إلى مغفرة من ربكم وجنة عرضها كعرض السماء والأرض.
Okay. والأرض. It's very simple. I don't you feel like you're snatching the letter. Take it easy. Say عرضها كعرض السماء والأرض.
عرضها كعرض السماء والأرض.
والأرض.
ولا أرض.
لا, not ولا. Because ولا, you know, you just put فتحة on top of the lam. Look at it. The lam has سكون, right?
نعم.
So you will say, والأرض. Say, والأرض.
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 Excellent. Continue now.
أعدت للذين آمنوا بالله ورسوله.
We just stretched out the little ضمة of آمنوا. Because there is مادة طبيعية there. آمنوا بالله. آمنوا بالله.
أعدت للذين آمنوا بالله ورسوله.
Great.
ذلك فضل الله يؤتيه من يشاء والله.
The واو has Hamza on top. Look at the واو, right?
نعم.
What kind of vowel is on top of the واو and the Hamza?
What?
سكون.
سكون.
And the سكون is like يؤتيه. A stop sign. It's not non-vowel letter. So يؤتيه.
يؤتيه.
Okay. Excellent. Okay. ذلك فضل الله يؤتيه من يشاء.
ذلك فضل الله يؤتيه من يشاء. والله ذو الفضل العظيم.
Okay. Before you continue, I like to recommend something to the students who are beginners. Learning the Quran. If you may think that this is like a good size Quran to read, I would say no. Make sure that you have even a bigger size so that the font would be bigger, the vowels would be clearer because you are in the process of learning. Mm-hmm. Because the Quran is not like regular writing in a newspaper or in a regular book. No. You know, there are some letters which have vowels on top that you must pronounce it different from other letters and so on. So you have to pay close attention to that. And in order to help you in this regard, you have to have a bigger font. continue. We'll take one more ayah, inshallah. ما أصاب.
ما أصاب من مصيبة في الأرض ولا في.
Remember, we said الأرض.
الأرض.
Yes.
ما أصاب من مصيبة في الأرض ولا في أنفسكم إلا في كتاب من قبل أن نبرأها إن ذلك على الله يسير.
حسبك بارك الله فيك. Inshallah, we have something to talk about with you, inshallah, hopefully next episode, and share with the viewers. But now we ran out of time. By the end, we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to make us from Ahlul Quran, الَّذِينَ هُمْ أَهْلُ اللَّهِ وَخَاصَّتُهُ, and grants the knowledge of the Quran, the wisdom of the Quran, enable us to ponder over the Quran and act upon the Quran, the word of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Brothers and sisters, love you all for the sake of Allah. Until next week, assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.
And sisters, to increase your iman, read the miracle, recite the Quran, recite it every day and do read it loud. The verses of Quran are all Muslims' pride. This miracle was revealed over a long time span, sent from Allah to an angel, then to a man. That man was Muhammad, the best of creation. We were chosen to be part of his nation. He gave us a message, and that was Islam. So read this miracle, recite the Quran.